I think just seeing the joy that comes to people's faces when we provide them fresh local flowers, it seems like there's a lot of nostalgia around it. Flowers remind people of situations or things in their past.
When you're dealing with local flowers, you can deal with 30, 40 different, you know, flowers that are available per season. So there's a lot of diversity in that. And I think people appreciate that, as well as the fact that the flowers typically last longer.
My name is Priscilla Wentworth Leach, and this is Anchored Roots Farm. And we're here in St. Mary's County, Maryland. Anchored Roots Farm name came about because I have a strong connection here to St. Mary's County, and my family has been here for a really long time, and we just feel like we're anchored to the roots of this land. It's sort of a play on both the land and the water and being connected to it and being out here in nature.
Hi, I'm Bahia Parks, and this is Eco Blossoms Farm, and right now we're in my peony field. For me, when I'm thinking about a landscape, I want to choose plants that are going to thrive in that environment. So I choose plants that are usually native to the area as much as possible. And if they're not native to the area, certainly they're plants that can deal with that fluctuation of temperature and, you know, still have the beauty. And it's all about what the actual client wants.
I'm Ray Greenstreet with Greenstreet Growers and Greenstreet Gardens. We're just south of Annapolis in Lothian near Deal, Maryland, and we're at our Maryland Retail Garden Center. Agriculture is the number one industry in the state of Maryland, and I wave the big flag with that. We've got a very supportive governor who has understood how important agriculture is, and horticulture, greenhouse, wholesale, retail, and nursery is a big part of that, as well as the landscape industry.
There's only so many flowers that ship. However, if grown locally and here in Maryland, we can grow over 60 to 80 different varieties of flowers just in one season. And so we have a lot more variety, different textures, and different things to work with than what you might see in a grocery store.
Now we have all different types of breeding going on and different types of plants. And some of the plants that were my grandmother's favorite, my mom's, are now, they're back in vogue. You know, it's like the cool plant. We also are still a rooting station, so we actually take all these plants, and we have little tiny rooty cuttings, and they come in from all over the world, Costa Rica, Nicaragua, Israel, and we actually root them, and then we ship them to other growers, and that's their starter plants.
Local florists are more willing to work with local flower farmers now, and that's a really great thing, and particularly customers are asking for that. So brides particularly want to support local flowers, so I'm very appreciative of that.
Most of us here in Southern Maryland that are growing flowers are very small farms. And Becky of Red Tree Farmstead is one of those other small growers like myself who we kind of have found ourselves in a position where we may not always be able to meet the demand in the marketplace because we are so small. And so we've started a partnership where we'll grow a lot of the same varieties of flowers to provide more flowers to a bigger market. I learned a lot about plants just through osmosis, just through growing up with my dad being in the nursery business and all of his brothers. There's been a lot of great organizations who have sort of helped on the marketing side, helped on the education side, organizations like SMADC, to really help us who are getting into farming and new and beginning farmers get going.
Anyone who's interested in becoming a farmer, I really suggest reaching out to other farmers, and you'll get really a wonderful support. I've always had great support from the farming community here.
You know, it's human nature. You want to be close to something green. And we really saw that with the pandemic. I mean, it really, I had some people walk through, some ladies walk through, and they had like tears in their eyes. You know, they had just been confined for so long, they had to touch something green and get into some green space.
And I think it's really important for us to always stay connected to nature and always kind of understanding the plants and always understanding what's going on out here is really kind of important to us.
I'm a big believer in comfort and just creating a really comfortable, cozy environment and having it be an expression of, you know, just life and joy.
Plants are, they're really easy. The thing that plants want is some consistency. I think you'll find that bringing plants in, not only for the aesthetics, but also for your health, mental and physical.
I always say I have 1,000 babies because I love to take care of plants. Always keeping an eye on them through the winter and watching them kind of slowly come into bloom as everything wakes up in the spring is probably my favorite thing about the farm.
There's just all kinds of studies about how people are healthier and happier with plants. Plants are important.